So welcome to this session on web server and server products. So in this particular session, we will discuss what is meant by web server, which are various available web servers, and what are different server products available. So that is nothing but the agenda of this particular session. Now begin with the server. So server, normal, the server, it is nothing but a computer with server software, which provides specific kind of service to the client. As the word server, it is serving something to the client, serving something. So hence it is called a server, which will give you some specific kind of service to the client. So there are many types of servers available. So those servers are like application server, catalog server, computing server, database server, game server, mail server, web server. So we'll take example like a computing server. So the computing server will provide you the computational power, and by using that service you can compute the huge calculation. So that is nothing but what we can say computing server. Now database server means it is a server where you are storing a database. So that will act as a database server. There is a game server. In while playing multiple players game, at that time you have to put one server as a game server and other as a client. There is a mail server, there is a web server. So those are the various types of servers available. Now the servers are acting like a client and server architecture. So what is by client and what is by server? So server means who is serving to the clients, and client is nothing but the one who wants something to be served or who wants some service. So that is nothing but a client. So first of all, server is a piece of hardware or software. It may be hardware or it may be software, which provide a service to one or more clients. So there are multiple clients as per their request. For example, we'll take example of Google. The Google server is located somewhere, and many people, means there are lakhs of people, they are together, wants the mail service, they want the drive service. Drive service is nothing but the storage service. A mail service is nothing but the mail server is providing. So mail service, lakhs of people, they want the mail service, and the server, Google server, is providing that service. So Google is a server, and as the client means we want mail as a service, and we are as a client. So server means it is a piece of hardware. It may be hardware or it may be software, and which provide a service to many or one or more clients. Now what is by client? Client is contacting server for some service, particular service, and wait for service. We have to discuss the example once again. We want Google to serve us Gmail. So we are logging into Gmail account with username and password, and we are waiting for a few seconds or few seconds, and Google server will provide you list of emails available in your inbox. So that is nothing but the service. So we are waiting for some time. The client is waiting for some time for the service, and server will provide in between. Now this is what we have, the client server architecture. Here is the server, and client is requesting for some service, and the server will serve that request. So this is nothing but how there are multiple clients, one client. So this is called as client server architecture. Now we'll discuss about the web server. Now whenever it is dealing with the website, that is nothing but a web server. So what is a web server? Web server is a computer that runs website. So as I have told, for hosting a website, for running the website, you must host that website somewhere. So that is nothing but a web server. You have to host somewhere, and then only that website will be accessible. So web server is a computer that runs website. Now web server is a program. This is one more explanation of web server. Web server is a program which uses HTTP, means hypertext transfer protocol, to serve web pages to the user based on their request. The web server is a program which uses hypertext transfer protocol to serve web pages. Now web server, what it does, it stores, processes, and delivers web pages to the user. So it will store the web pages, it will process the something, and it will deliver the web pages to the user. So based on the request, based on the things, the server will do some operations and it will give the result. For example, if suppose we have banking, in case of banking, we have the bank server and we are using the internet banking. So in that case, we are requesting something. Means suppose we want to suppose transfer money from one place to other place. So we are requesting, and based on our inputs, the server will do the calculation and it will transfer the money and it will give the response that transaction is completed. So that is nothing but it will store, as well as after transferring the money, it will deduct the money from your account. It means it is processing. It is processing. So it means the web server, it will store, process, as well as deliver the web pages to the user. Now, more than 80% of the websites, those are running on the open source web servers. Now, what is by open source and what is by proprietary? Open source means the software which can be used by anyone without any licensing, without means you need not to pay for that website, that is called as open source. In case of proprietary, you have to pay some money for using the things. So that is nothing but called as proprietary. So more than 80% websites running on the open source web servers. Now here is the web server, how it looks. If suppose this is a web client, it will request something through the internet. This request will pass to the server, server having the database. And based on the request, server will process that request using some database, and it will reply to the web client through the internet. So this is nothing but how it works. It will ask for something. It is nothing but a request. It is requesting server for giving the service. And based on the request, server will reply and web client will get the reply. So that is nothing but how it works, web server as well as the web client, how they are working. So everywhere you will find the client and server. Client means asking for something, and server means giving something, serving something, serving. And client means taking. So this is called as the client and server model. Now the available leading web servers in the market are Apache HTTP server. You have Apache Tomcat server. Then you have Node.js server. Then you have LightTPD server. Then you have NGINX server. And you have Sun Java System web server. So those are the, this is the list of servers available today, like Apache HTTP, Apache Tomcat, Node.js, LightTPD, NGINX, Sun Java System web server. Now we'll begin with the Apache HTTP server. So it is referred, this Apache HTTP server, it is also referred as HTTPD or Apache. So this is the most popular web server, with more than 50% website are powered by it. Means more than 50% website, they are using the Apache HTTP server. And it is referred as a HTTPD. Now another server is Apache Tomcat. So it is a free open source environment for Java servlet. So it is an open source implementation of Java servlet. It is mostly used for deploy and serve Java web application. So Apache Tomcat, it is mostly used for deploying and serving the Java web applications. Now next server is Node.js server. It is related to JavaScript. So it is a JavaScript environment for network application as a web server. So this Node.js, it is a cross-platform runtime environment. What is my cross-platform? It can work on any platform, like Linux platform. It will work on Windows platform. Any platform it will work. So it is nothing but a cross-platform runtime environment. It has small market share, but this is taking popularity nowadays as a Node.js server. Next server is LightTPD. So it is the popular server for Catalyst and Ruby on Rails web frameworks. So those are the frameworks, web development frameworks like Catalyst and Ruby on Rails. So LightTPD, it is very much popular among those web servers, web frameworks, and they are using this particular server. Now next server is NGINX. This is the second most popular open source web server. So NGINX, it is the second popular web server, open source web server. This is popular due to light resource utilization. So what is my light resource utilization? It is using resources, very limited resources. Means if you are taking the example of RAM, example of processing power. So very low resources are used by NGINX, as well as you can scale it easily. You can change it easily So that is nothing but the popularity due to the light resource utilization and scale easily for the NGINX. Next server, web server, that is a Sun Java System web server. So Sun Microsystem, it is a company who has developed this web server suitable for medium and large websites. So this is suitable for medium and large websites. So this server, it runs on Windows, Linux or Unix platform. So this can run on Windows as well as Linux or Unix platform. So Sun Java System web server, it is the web server suitable for medium or large websites. Now, after discussing various servers, available servers, we are moving towards various server products. First server product is Macromedia Cold Fusion. So this is the commercial platform. This is commercial fast web development computing platform. So it is a commercial, means you have to pay for it. So Macromedia Cold Fusion, you have to pay for it, and this will provide you web development computing platform. Now, second server product is Microsoft ASP and .NET. So it is server-side scripting language. So Microsoft ASP and .NET, it is a server-side scripting language and acting as an engine for dynamic web pages. This is an engine for the dynamic web pages. And third server product is Java 2 Enterprise Edition. So this is the mainly useful for web development related to Java pages or Java. So Java 2 Enterprise Edition, it is also called as Java 2 EE. So it is mainly useful for web development. So those are the server products we have. So this is all about what is a web server, what is my server, what are different web servers available, and what are different server products with us. So thank you for joining this particular session.